Welcome to Resilience, a meditative walk with stories of resilience illustrated in art, written in scripture, read in poetry, and spoken in the sharing of personal stories. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm here again in the sacred space at the Los Angeles Religious Education Congress in Anaheim, California. And as always, my good friends are joining me as we explore some highlights of the sacred space this year. We have Valerie McRae. How are you, Valerie?
I'm doing well. Thank you.
Excellent. And of course, Giovanni Perez. How are you?
Very good. Thank you very much.
Awesome. And we're starting with this piece, Valerie, this is yours. And one thing that, as we were speaking right before we started the taping, this is such a powerful and hopeful piece. And one thing that sticks out to me is the verdant green tones, which in my sort of interpretation are very much symbolic of the green pastures and that hopefulness for better things to come, someone who is rising up. Just give us a brief, you know, summary of your artistic interpretation here.
This one is called Blessed. And I think when you get to that moment, and probably after you do this walk, when you come to the end where you have risen up, our theme this year is rise up. And I found this image and it just spoke to me of rising up. And when you finally rise up and realize how blessed you are, you cannot help but just be overjoyed. And the colors are vibrant. They're not just yellow. There's like apple greens and teals and all the different kinds of colors going on. And little flecks of gold leafing falling down, and those represent the little bits of blessing, and they kind of tie in with the other paintings you're going to see. So,
and Giovanni, I think as men sometimes we are not necessarily given agency to express what we feel, but this man is so invigorated and he seems so relieved that he is extending his arms to the heavens. As you prepared this whole space, what were some of the thoughts and prayers that were sort of living in your heart as you embarked on this sacred space journey?
Thank you for mentioning that. It is about being able to be integrated and expressing that which touches your soul. I mean, lifting up your arms. Sometimes we're so uncomfortable with our bodies. But the prayers that continue to pour on my heart and on the hearts of the team were those of resilience. See, the gold, the blessings that come down from the painting is that only through being tested by the fire, by being in the dark soul of the night, the dark night of the soul, that's when we experience the blessings coming from above, from our God. So we will hear throughout the walk stories of resilience, stories of people and organizations that have faced difficult moments of their lives or difficult moments of others' lives, and they have risen up to the occasion.
All right, let's see some of those stories and some of those images. Standing at station 4, and this is Faith and Goodness, and of course very prominent are these, I don't know if I want to call them magenta or maroon hands, but they really inform the piece and they seem to touch upon this central figure in a way that almost seems healing and restorative. Valerie, if you could just tell us a little bit about the artistry of this piece.
Well, with Angelica's paintings, she has her own personal stories about the paintings, but she leaves the stories sort of hidden so that you can come up with your own interpretation of the story. For me, when I looked at this one, I thought of the story of Lazarus and how they were asked to unbind him. He didn't unbind himself. He was unbound by other people. So these hands are kind of coming through. That may not be, everyone's interpretation of this, but I also like the the idea of the spheres, or the almost like bubbles that are coming up. And you can see the texture in the painting. It's also circular. There's a lot of circular things happening, so a lot of movements is happening with this. So you can imagine, you know, being unbound, or you know, the healing, maybe just the healing touch.
Yeah.
You know, the idea of just touch is so healing. We don't do that often enough. So we all have that. We all have that ability to heal with our touch.
Yeah, and I think, Giovanni, one thing that really captivated us is that one of the figures in the story that accompanies this piece is someone that a lot of us know. It's Father Greg Boyle, and one of the ministries that he's involved with. So can you tell us a little bit about the story here?
Absolutely. The as the hands reach out, we selected the story of the Mothers of Dolores Mission, one of the poorest parishes in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, located in East LA, Boyle Heights to be more exact. And these were the women that pushed Father Greg Boyle to lead the community into helping the young people that were falling victims of gang violence, street violence, drugs. And that's because of the work that these women did, Homeboy Industries came to be. Homegirl Cafe came to be. Homeboy Bakery came to be. And that touching not only moved them and gave them a job, but like Valerie well said, healed the community. I mean, these were people that could only see darkness all around them. But because of the women that were determined that their muchachos, that their boys, the girls, were being killed on the streets, they did not stop until they saw the light, and they touched, and they touched, and they continued to touch.
I have to say that there is a very maternal, very female-inspired energy in this piece, and, you know, Monica praying 33 years for the conversion of St. Augustine, and the tenacity that we know that mothers can have, and that faith is very, very inspiring. So we've reached Station 6, and this is such a personal piece and story, this concept of our belief in humanity, because here in the City of Angels, we have a real issue with our homeless population. And so once I heard the story that really animated this piece, Valerie, it couldn't be more than compelling for us as Catholics who understand the option for the poor and the necessity to really give our gifts and give glory to God through giving assistance to our brothers and sisters. Artistically, this is also very powerful. Can you talk to us about the imagery and what we're seeing here?
I can talk about what I see. And everybody's going to see something different. Giovanni, you know, opened my eyes to a few images in here. I'll let him talk about those. But this has so much symbolism in it. And you really have to digest this and let it sink in. I mean, you said City of Angels, and so I can look at that and see angel wings, you know, coming through. So that's City of Angels. I see the little triangles, which for me is like a city, you know, it's many structures. And then certainly the spirituality behind the human image in the front. And the colors are, again, vibrant. But I think the interpretation is going to be with each person being able to pick out that one symbol that speaks to them or resonates inside of them. And that's a great thing about art. That certainly wasn't Angelica's intention, I don't think. But we are allowed our interpretation.
And so Giovanni, wow, the story of this man and what he was doing and is continuing to do is pretty awe-inspiring, definitely. Can you tell us a little bit?
Very inspiring. His name is Elvis Summers. He's a native of LA. He started out by meeting this one lady in the neighborhood. Everybody would say hi to her until he finally asked her, where do you live? And he showed him where she, and she showed him where she lived. It was a spot in the dirt. And in his words, he says, it ticked me off to see that this woman, who everybody said hi, didn't have a place to sleep. So he decided to build her a house, a very small room, simply because he wanted people to have a safe place to sleep. And he has built over, well, in the thousands of these little houses. You might see them out on the street on down Figueroa. It's quite amazing. This man who has no religious affiliation, to be honest with you, but decided that every human being needed a safe place to be. It really touched my heart. And this is a man who has a soul of gold. And what I see in the painting, if I am allowed, on the right-hand side of the painting, there is one triangle, which I thought, man, that's a tent. And then on the other side of the painting, there are many triangles. One act of charity, one act of courage, one act of reaching out became an ongoing movement of Elvis Summers to provide something good, to see the dignity and the personhood of each individual.
Yeah, definitely. Giving glory to God and trying to make a dent in those 58,000 souls that are in need. So one of the pieces that we've chosen is Station 2, which is Light and Darkness. The light breaks through the darkness. And Valerie, one thing that really captivated me with this piece is just how sheer the contrast is between light and dark, and how exhilarating it must be to emerge triumphant from, you know, the depths of that nadir, that low point, and really break through into the light, into that space that really gives us luminosity and vigor.
And these paintings are all done by Angelica Sotier, and she starts off with a black canvas, and then what she does is she builds upon that blackness, darkness, and she builds light and layers of light until she continues with, at the very end, putting her gold leafing on the top. And she's Greek Orthodox, and that's her experience with her faith. So I think that it's quite appropriate to go from the darkness and continue to build out with the light. So I think it's beautiful.
And Giovanni, the story that sort of informs this station and this piece is quite compelling. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Absolutely. The common thread throughout the exhibit is the story of the raising of Lazarus. And so there is a passage in the story in which Jesus says, no one that walks in the light will stumble, only those that walk in the darkness. So you have to come out of the darkness and see the light in order to be able to see better, to be able to walk freely. The story that is being told behind this painting is that of Alexandria House. Women and children trying to put their lives back together after domestic abuse, after moments of real darkness in their lives, and trying to say, we need to step out of the darkness.
That's really, really inspiring, and I think that you're right. One theme that we see throughout the entire exhibit is just that sheer moment when you stumble into the light and you become a new person. So the next piece we're going to see also really much touches on that theme. So we've reached the end here, and of course all roads lead to Christ, to the cross. Our bearing powerful symbol of sacrifice and love and transcendence. And this one is called Untie. Leave here what binds you. And so participants have this piece of cloth that they bring with them along this sacred space journey. And here they have an opportunity to deposit, to leave with Christ that which they may have brought with them here to this Congress, or something that they may have been carrying for several months or even years. And this is the perfect opportunity after this contemplation, after hearing all those other stories of folks who have been victorious and who are doing good deeds and are living the gospel in their lives. This is a moment to deposit that. So we're going to give Valerie and Giovanni an opportunity to do that here for us as we say goodbye to you in this great journey of sacred space. Thank you for your ministry and for always being there for us. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you.